What's up, guys, and welcome to another episode. And this is Battlefield 1. It's in my console, ready to play, and finally get to do a little video to show you guys and offer the chance to possibly get you into something that maybe you've never taken any interest in or gotten an experience for yourself. And before I do that, I just wanted to give you a little intro in this video before I jump into this game and show you what it has to offer. And whenever it came down to military shooters and multiplayer games that has mainly focused on the spectacles of war as a type of fictional entertainment, so, you know, perhaps, it's always been kind of a difficult genre for me to play and immerse myself into. It's not just from the overwhelming community and the annualization of these type of games and IPs. It's really because out of all the over-the-top violence I consume and enjoy and see all around me when it comes to entertainment, the history and stories of war and just war itself is just the most evil type of thing that we as human beings put on this earth could have possibly ever done. I mean, to use violence as the answer on such a grand scale to deal with our problems, it's I'm honestly speechless. I mean, I don't know what to fucking say right now. I mean, war is just pure death and destruction. It destroys lives mentally and physically. It rips the joy and history of families and wildlife and cities and countries just completely apart. War has, it just ruins everything. There's never been anything good that's come out of it. I mean, yes, we have eliminated some terrible, terrible people, but the cost of what was spent to reach those terrible people nearly demoralizes the victory itself. And the reasons why war even occurs and even happens in the first place can be just as sickening as the war taking place. I mean, it's just fucking crazy. Because it just proves what we as people will fight for. To all of you who know me personally, and to all who have watched and listened to me on this channel throughout the years, if there was anything you could say about me to anyone if they was ever to ask, it's you definitely know how much I really, really love video games and how important they've been to me throughout my whole life, and how immersed I get into the story and atmosphere, and how much I love grotesque horror, intense violence, brutal martial arts and fist fights and over-the-top action, and that, oh, look at that old lady over there, throw a grenade at her, yeah, type of stuff. I mean, you know I'm all in about that type of stuff. It's just so crazy how often people's temper has led them to violence on others, and people's depression, neglection, greed, and addictions has led to feelings of hate and anger and having no remorse for whatsoever for human life. And it just breaks my heart to see these things happening on the news and around the world. The thought of using your own struggles in life as an answer to lead you to commit such acts of violence and death of so many innocent lives, it is something that I will just never understand and just never fully. I'll just never understand it. I'll never understand how something could lead you to commit something so vile and senseless. And it's so crazy how, like, that has been our way of life as people for, like, the last 150 years. Just even more than that, just violence for everything. Anybody with power, just, my God, the history of people is just absolutely insane. It's like it's a horror story, pretty much. But yeah, I'm not trying to go on and on and on and on. I don't know. I'm just talking and speaking my mind, I guess. It's just, all in all, war is every emotion wrapped into one. Every emotion and feeling except love, peace, and happiness. But anyways, I just wanted to give you guys a few thoughts and reasons why I really don't play too many of these games, unless if there's a very kind of a, I guess, a message to it, kind of like what Battlefield 1's doing, which I'm really digging the presentation of it. And so all in all, I really do enjoy quite a few of these games. I just wish they would focus a bit more on the single player part of it more than the multiplayer part, but I know how the video game industry is these days. Yeah, I just wish they would focus more on, like, the consequences and the dramas of war rather than the fantasy and spectacle of being in just numerous battles, I guess. But all that aside, I hope you guys enjoy this Let's Play and experience the opening act for this game and dive into a war that has never really been talked about that much compared to others. And I just really felt like this was something special, and I just had to make a video after completing it. I hope you guys sit down, relax, put on some headphones, and just let me take you through the opening for this fairly well-crafted campaign. And I think about how real war actually is. But at the same time, I want you guys to enjoy yourself. I mean, besides sounding like a straight downer, this is an impressive game in a very, very popular series. So I love you guys very much. Thank you for letting me talk and let a bit of steam off of my chest and just talk about, I don't know, just the stress of living in this world. I love you guys very much. I hope you guys enjoy it. And again, thank you very much. Take care.
We came from all over the world. So many of us thinking this war would be our rite of passage, our great adventure. Let me tell you, it was no adventure. Killing machines, like the tank, changed the shape of the war overnight. Luckily, they were mostly on our side. Mostly.
Our boys in the church are overrun. We need to push through. PBI are counting on us. Use that!
We found fear, and in war, the only true equalizer is death. they push, we push. Every once in a while, we push hard enough that the light breaks through the clouds and a world beyond the war glimmers, just out of reach. The war is the world, and the world is the war. But behind every gun sight is a human being. We are those people. We are the jaded, we are the naive, we are the honorable, and the criminal. We are the bound for legend and the lost to history. We are the knights of the sky, the ghosts in the desert, and the rats in the mud. These are our stories.